Alabama, Louisiana, seven states have left our precious Union. There's a storm headed this way, and it's coming soon. Hell, you people know it. Some of you already suffered because of it. But unless you sign with me and put your life on the line for these United States, that suffering is gonna get a whole lot worse.
Fella's got a point.
A lot of people I know wouldn't agree with that sort of talk.
Well, if somebody don't agree on something pretty soon, talk is gonna be the least of our worries.
Who's gonna be the first to sign up and defend this great country of ours? I have two brave volunteers.
Good boys, good
boys. Go on home to your mama. You got lives to live this man shouldn't take away from you.
Who the hell are you?
You signed my son up on your last recruiting trip. Told him you was full of lies, but he didn't know better. If he had, he never would have joined with the likes of you.
What are you running on about, mister?
You took my boy away from me. 3 weeks later, you sent him home in a box.
One of the greatest things a man can do is die for his country.
He died in a border skirmish that should have never happened. My boy was only 13 years old.
Man's age don't matter. Just his convictions. Don't listen to him, boys. You'll be joining one of the finest groups of fighting men. Hold it! Hold it!
Damn. One, back up.
One!
Back off!
Let it go!
You already took one of your sons. Don't push him any further.
You stay out of this.
You're a real inspiration to these folks. You drawing on an unarmed man.
You start listening to cowards, this country don't have a chance. Let's go.
Come on home.
Thought you were on his side.
I agree with the cause. It's not the way he goes about it.
Hard day?
You hungry?
Too tired to eat.
Looks like that blacksmith is working you pretty hard.
Too hard.
Hard work builds character.
Just what this town needs, another character. Teaspoon, I gotta get another job.
Well, what you got in mind?
I wanna be an express rider.
Oh, you do, huh?
You don't think I could do it?
Well, I think you could do anything you set your mind to, but the fact is, Russell Majors and Waddell have set an age requirement, and you ain't quite there yet.
So lie.
I don't cotton to lying.
Well, you weren't in too much of a hurry to tell him the truth about Lou.
Well, that's different. She's ready.
I'm ready, Teaspoon. Believe me, I'm ready.
Son. Why are you in such an all-fired hurry all the time?
Because I want to do something important.
Something I can do for you?
Quinn!
What?
Quinn Ellis, that's my name.
Dixon,
Noah Dixon. You're an express rider?
Yeah. Thanks for clearing that up for me.
So, I really thought it was great the way you put that Libra and fella in his place yesterday.
Well, now, I didn't do all that much.
Should have done more.
Look.
Quinn Ellis?
Yeah, right. A fella like LeBrant just needs his attitude adjusted. Violence never solved anything.
Quinn Ellis!
That's you, right?
Quinn?
That's my sister.
Quinn Ellis, where's that soap I sent you to get?
Soap. Right, soap! Yeah, I was on my way to get it when, well, you see, when I go get that soap.
I'm afraid I'm to blame, Miss C. Quinn and I, well, he sort of started talking and...
With you and the rest of the town. Besides, don't make no difference whose fault it was. Fact is, there's a job to be done and he wasn't doing it.
Her name's Cassie Ellis.
Mm-hmm.
Works in the laundry, her brother helps out.
Him I met.
Well, the two of them are inseparable. From what I hear, she raised the boy herself.
You seem mighty interested in this Cassie Ellis.
Well, ain't nothing wrong with being interested.
No, nothing at all. Of course, you may want to ask her some of these questions instead of me.
Mm-hmm. 10 cents, that's double last week's price.
Well, new owner ain't interested in making friends.
Ain't friends I'm interested in.
Couldn't be.
He's 1,000 miles away.
I know that, and you know that.
But it looks like somebody forgot to tell him.
Mr. Tompkins, what are you doing here?
I'm running my new store. You know, you folks had the right idea leaving Sweetwater and coming over here where the action is. And with all that talk about the war, McCoy's widow was anxious to sell this store. And you know, I'm always willing to help a needy individual.
You mean fleece a needy individual?
Oh, I can't deny I did get a bit of a deal. But a man's got to eat.
Not at these prices. Well, you're doing your best to get in my way. Well, as long as you're here, maybe you ought to make yourself useful and fetch me a couple bottles of that whiskey over there.
I don't work here.
I'll get that for you, Sergeant.
No, I want the boy here to do it. He owes me for what he did yesterday.
I owe this town an apology for not finishing it yesterday.
Noah.
You want a piece of me, don't you, boy?
I wouldn't dirty my hands.
Yeah, I'm not finished talking to you. I'll let you know when you...
I don't want no part of this in my store. Rachel, just leave that list and I'll see everything you need is brought over later.
Come on, Noah. Come on. You know better than this.
I always thought I did, Rachel.
Cassie. Hi, I'm Noah Dixon. We didn't get properly introduced yesterday.
I know who you are. Quinn hasn't stopped talking about you.
I can imagine.
Yeah, he tends to go on, but he's a good kid. Seen each other through a lot of bad times. Is there something I can help you with?
Well, I ain't been in town long, and I don't know many folks. Wondering if maybe you might have some time to show me around.
I got more than I can handle, and with taking care of Quinn and all...
Well, you could ask him to come with. Wouldn't be any lack for conversation.
So this is where you run to.
I don't run from nothing.
What's the matter? That white trash wouldn't put up with you? So you headed back to your own kind?
I don't like you, and you don't like me. Things would be a whole lot better around here if you and me just went our separate ways.
Anxious for me to leave, huh? If she's given away for free, Maybe I ought to get in line.
Going back inside. If you ever come near her again, so help me, I'll kill you!
What the winner looks like, I'd hate to see what the loser looks like. Come on.
No, he couldn't feel any worse than I do.
Well, I guess it's inevitable, the two of you mixing it up like that.
I'd feel a whole lot better about it if I felt like it was the end of it. A fella like Lieber, and he ain't gonna be happy till one of us is dead.
Mm-hmm. Rachel?
Hello, Cassie. Quinn.
Miss Rachel?
Came to see how Noah's doing. Brought you your hat.
Thanks.
Guess you got around to asking those questions after all. Maybe Quinn'd like to come over to the barn and see our new foal?
Oh, who wants to see horses? I want to hear about the fight.
Quinn?
Oh, all right.
Did you see it? How many times did he hit it?
Well, you can't fault the kid's enthusiasm.
It's been like that since he was a baby. It's been some trying times raising him.
Can't imagine anybody could have done a good as job as you.
Well, don't want to wear you out. You gotta get your rest.
You don't have to be going now, do you?
Well, I got half of yesterday's work to do, and it's practically tomorrow. Besides, I just wanted to see how you were doing. And say thanks.
Well, least I could do is stick up for you.
It's not worth it.
Why not?
Because I'm not worth it.
Talking about you.
Let them talk. Don't matter to me.
I would if you heard what Liebrand was saying.
What he says matters least of all.
Where you headed?
Just gotta set some things straight.
Noah, what are you doing up so early?
We still have some things to talk about. Now, I set out to talk to you last night, but I thought it best I sleep on it.
But I thought we...
Look, I don't know you very well, but you have to let me talk to you.
Noah, things are a lot more complicated than you think.
Well, sometimes things are a lot simpler with two.
Noah! Teaspoon's looking for you.
Well, can it wait?
Liebrand's dead.
How?
Stabbed in the back. Jesse found him in an alley.
Any idea who did it?
I was hoping you could help me out on that one.
What are you saying, Teaspoon?
Noah, I ain't accusing you of nothing, but you ought to know a lot of people are.
Why, just because I had a fight with him? Half the town wanted to see him dead.
Problem is, the other half heard you say it in the middle of the street. Son, I'm trying to figure this out.
There's got to be something I can do to help this fool.
Best thing you can do is go back to the station, stay out of sight.
I ain't one to duck trouble.
I don't like this any better than you do, but the way things are in this town, people are just looking for an excuse to get all riled up. I don't want you to be it.
All I saw was Noah and Liebrand fighting. Of course, I did hear the boy say he wanted to kill him. But what the hell? A man can't be responsible for everything he says.
Tompkins, you sure ain't changed much.
Well, when I find something that works, I stick with it.
Where are we going now?
I thought you were supposed to be working.
We got off early. Wanted to give you a hand.
Doing what?
Finding Liebrand's murderer. Got a lot of ideas.
I'm sure you do.
Been asking around.
What have you been asking?
Questions. Lots of them. Seems everybody in town's talking about the murder. Finding out who did it's a real important thing.
Oh, so that's what this is all about.
Yep. What?
You. doing something important.
That obvious, huh?
I can't believe anyone would think Noah's a murderer.
From what I hear, no one's giving him a chance.
It ain't gonna matter much if they find out we don't know where he went last night.
I went for a walk. I guess a man my color ain't allowed to do that around here, huh?
You know it ain't like that, Noah.
The hell I don't. Teaspoon want me to hold up here like a caged animal.
Teaspoon's got your best interest at heart.
Oh, that's easy for you to say. Because you ain't colored, and you ain't accused of killing a white man. Your sister around?
She's kind of busy at the moment.
Yeah, well, I really need to talk to her.
Well, now's not the right time, Noah.
Noah!
Cassie. Look, I know you don't want to talk to me.
Well, who told you that? Quinn. Inside.
For Cassie?
Now. He's always been overprotective. I've got to pick up some laundry. If you want to come with me, we can talk then.
Okay. Folks around here look about ready to measure my neck for a noose. Even my friends looking at me different.
Don't know how much trouble you're in, do you?
No, I can handle it. Still, it ain't easy talking to them.
But you're talking to me.
I know.
Don't make sense. You said it yourself, you hardly know me.
Well, maybe that's what makes it easier.
What you should be doing is getting yourself out of town.
I ain't the sort to run. Besides, there's so much I want to tell you.
I don't think that's a wise idea. Anyway, I gotta get back to
Cassie,
work.
Cassie, if I thought your walking away from me is what you really wanted, I'd let you do it. But I don't. I'll come by tomorrow after you're done working. We'll go for a ride. Put some distance between us and this town.
No, I don't think that.
Just think about it, okay?
All right. I'll think about it.
Saloon owner said Liebrandt stumbled out of there sometime after midnight. He was the last person to see him alive.
I appreciate it, Cody.
Marshal Hunter?
That's right.
Colonel Edwin Sawyer, assistant to the adjutant general. I'm here to apprehend the killer of Sergeant Liebrandt.
Well, as soon as we find him, we'll turn him over to you.
Marshal, I know you have your job to do. I have mine. The fact is, we're both looking for the same man. I see no reason to step on each other's toes while we're looking.
I agree.
Seems like an awful lot of trouble to go through for a man like Liebrandt.
I knew Liebrandt. I didn't like him any better than the next person. He was mean, he was ornery, but he was a hell of a soldier. And right now, this country can't afford to lose anyone who's willing to fight for it.
Colonel, I understand what you're saying.
And you also understand that I have a murderer to find, and I'm not going to stop until I do. And when I do, he's going to hang.
Used to thinking about myself that way.
You ought to get in the habit.
You really think this is a good idea?
Best one I've had in weeks.
I don't know. That Colonel Sawyer's been asking questions all over town. All he's hearing is about how you and Liebrandt got into it.
Well, I can't stop people from talking.
man's gonna turn Rock Creek upside down till he comes up with someone. I just don't want it to be you.
You?
I'm Jesse James.
So?
Well, I'm trying to help Marshal Hunter find Liebrandt's killer.
I told that army fella everything I know.
Did you tell Sawyer about what Liebrandt did to your son?
I don't see how that's any concern of his. Or yours.
But...
Jesse! Over there, young man, right now. Batista. Now! I apologize, Carl. Sometimes that boy just gets out of line. Matter of fact, I've been meaning to talk to you myself.
About what?
I heard about what happened between you and Liebrandt.
Marshal, I'll save you the trouble. I didn't kill Liebrandt. If your colored rider did, I'll be the first to buy him a drink.
A man died here. Like it or not, I gotta find out who did it.
I ain't shedding a tear for Liebrandt. I've done all my grieving. Already. Come on back. Come on.
I was just trying to help.
Son, you're so busy thinking about yourself, you don't care who you hurt on the way. Keep heading in that direction. You're gonna be awful lonely when you get there.
Touched your food.
Guess I wasn't that hungry.
Hope it ain't the company.
Of course not. I just can't stop thinking about what's going on back in town.
Well, I thought that's why we came out here, Cassie, to get our minds off all that.
I can't. And I don't see how you can either. If I were you, I'd be 100 miles away by now.
That colonel is not gonna find one thing to tie me in with killing me.
I have seen his kind before. They get what they want, no matter what it takes. My town was filled with men like that.
What town was that?
It's not important.
Well, it is to me. I don't know anything about you, Cassie. And I'd really like to.
Me and Quinn was born in a plantation outside Baton Rouge. Stayed till I was 12, when suddenly Mama got us out of there.
They track you down?
Made it to Kansas. But then Mama got sick. The trip took its toll on her. As she was dying, she told me that my daddy was the master's son. He used to get drunk at night and have his way with the slave women. When Mama saw his eyes turn in my direction, she knew it was time to get us out of there. She died making sure what happened to her didn't happen to me.
Noah. Who wants to know?
Quinn Ellis, I'm Cassie's brother.
I know they were gone.
All right, look, they went to Willow Bluff, and they should have been back hours ago.
Look, you're asking the wrong person. Nobody wants to tell me anything.
I can see why.
I ain't got nothing else to tell you, except I know you're on the wrong track.
Well, I still haven't found anyone who was with Dixon on the night of the murder.
We also haven't found anyone who saw him with Lieber.
Something wrong, Colonel?
Listen, I understand you express riders are very attached to the boy, but that doesn't change the fact that Noah Dixon is most likely the person I'm looking for.
Well, then you ain't looked hard enough.
You're right. So I'm gonna look now where I should have looked in the first place.
You got no right to do this.
With all due respect, ma'am, I do have the right.
Rayshaw and Fleming don't got no choice. Territorial governor ordered me to cooperate with the colonel as much as possible.
Which one is Dixon's bunk?
That one.
You expect to find?
I don't expect to find anything, but I'm gonna look.
Yeah, well, you're wasting your time.
Am I? E.L. Earl Liebren.
Somebody must have put that in there.
Get the rest of the men. Find Noah Dixon.
Glad I came with you this afternoon.
Got a feeling things might be looking up.
Noah! Noah, you gotta get out of here.
Why?
What's wrong, Cody?
Sawyer ain't gonna listen to reason, and we ain't got time for a discussion that kid.
He's right. You have to.
Cassie,
it'd kill me to see you in jail. You gotta go.
There he is!
Do it for me.
I wouldn't go no further, Colonel Sawyer.
You will regret this.
Maybe so.
You had no right to shoot at Noah.
He was fleeing from an officer of the United States government who had ordered him not to resist.
Did he draw on you?
No. But he did.
That man's locked up. He ain't gonna do you a lot of harm.
The harm is done. So from now on, I don't want to see you or your riders. And if I do, these cells are gonna be very crowded.
Stay clear of Sawyer's men. They're in the frame of mind to catch you looking for Noah.
What do we do if we find him?
Lay low and let me know where you are. Maybe by then I can figure a way out of this mess.
We'll do our best.
Ride safe, Jimmy. Guess you ain't talking to me, huh?
Just you ain't interested in what I got to say.
Oh, it ain't that. Just that I'm so busy thinking about how to help Noah. Matter of fact, you ought to be thinking that way, too.
Jesse, how'd you find me?
Lucky guess. I figured you might need this stuff. How you doing?
I'm about as well as can be expected. Whole town still looking for me?
Ever since Sawyer found Lieberman's watch in your trunk.
I didn't put it there.
I know that, Noah. Maybe if Teaspoon finds out who did it, you can come back home.
How's Teaspoon bearing up?
He's doing fine. Though I ain't been much help to him.
Yeah, well, none of us have.
You know, sometimes Teaspoon really makes me mad. What really gets me is he's usually right.
More often than not. Appreciate you bringing me this stuff. Still can't figure out how you knew to come here, though.
Quinn was waiting outside the bunkhouse for you and Cassie. Said you'd gone to Willow Bluff. Figured it was worth a try.
Wait a minute. Quinn was waiting for us at the bunkhouse?
Yeah, what's wrong with that?
Everything.
Everyone's looking for you.
I ain't the one they ought to be looking for, am I? You killed Lieberman, didn't you?
What, are you crazy?
I know you were at the bunkhouse.
What are you talking about?
Jesse saw you there. You the one put Lieberman's watch in my trunk, ain't you? Ain't you?
I had to!
Why'd you try to blame me?
I said Cassie.
Cassie?
Don't you see she's the only thing I've got?
You didn't kill him, did you?
No. I did.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. I tried everything.
Don't let him take her away from me, please. Please don't let him take him away.
Quinn. Quinn. There's some things Noah and I need to talk about.
No. No. No.
We have to, baby. Please. Quinn, you just wait out here for us.
Everything's gonna be all right, isn't it? Isn't it?
It was a long day. And I was working very late. I was just about finished when Lieberman showed up. He was drunk.
Come here.
And had his mind on only one thing.
That's it. Come here. I'll show you.
I guess he thought having me was the best way to get back at you. I tried to fight him, but he was too strong. He forced himself on me. All I could see was Mama. She died trying to save me from this. And I wasn't gonna let it happen. I got my hands on some scissors. I didn't think twice about it. Quinn came out right after I killed him and helped me get rid of the body. I didn't know about him taking the watch until I heard him tell you.
He really loves you.
had known what Lee Brent did to you, I'd have killed him myself.
What are you gonna do?
I know what I'm doing, Teaspoon. I hear you've been looking for me.
Noah Dixon, you're under arrest for the murder of Sergeant Earl Liebrandt. Your gun, please.
Wait! Noah didn't kill that man. I did.
Cassie.
Show him what he did to you. Go on, Cassie. You have to.
Liebrandt did that.
And worse.
Colonel, you put this girl on trial, a whole lot of folks are gonna know what kind of man Liebrandt was. That ain't the image the Army's looking for, is it?
No trial necessary. This young lady's been through one already.
Ready to move?
Yes, sir. Ready?
We're all done here, folks. Go on home.
Left about. Forward. Move.